Hey everybody, I'd like to talk about the GoPro Hero 3 Black Edition. It's the latest product in GoPro's family of action cameras. I've been shooting with it for a few months and wanted to share a few thoughts. First, you must update the firmware and check for updates regularly. A few days after I got my Hero 3, I took a trip and failed to update the firmware and had big problems. The camera froze up and would stop recording, resulting in corrupt video files. After I returned home, I updated the firmware and have had no problems since. This camera has a whole new look and feel. It's smaller and lighter. It has several new and better recording format options. 4K at 15 frames per second, which is amazing, but most of us can't use. 2.7K at 30 frames per second, 1080 at 60 frames per second, and 720 at 120 frames per second. Incredible features in such a small package. It offers new field of view options, wide, medium, and narrow, very useful if you want to avoid the GoPro Extreme fisheye look. It has a better lens and an improved lens mount that protects the lens from dings. The Hero 3 comes with ProTune built in, which will allow you to set white balance, or shoot Cam Raw, which allows you to adjust the image in GoPro's Cineform software. If you've not downloaded it, you need to. It's very powerful and it's free. All the Hero 3s have Wi-Fi built in, and the Hero 3 Black comes with a Wi-Fi remote. It will also work nicely with the GoPro app and your smartphone or tablet. It has a new waterproof case with a much improved latch and a much needed flat lens for underwater shooting. The audio is better, but you will need the new mic adapter accessory to plug in an external mic. I recorded this audio with it. The new file numbering system is a big improvement. The camera is smaller and lighter, making it easier to mount. Many of my time-lapse rigs work better with this camera. Continuous record is a nice new feature that many have overlooked. If you're waiting for action, set the camera to record a 5-minute loop. You don't have to record hours of material to get the shot. It's great for dash cam applications. You just wait till you see your shot and stop the camera. I love the better quality in stills mode. My night time lapses look great. The Hero 3 does have some problems. This camera gets hot. I guess they got the extra performance by overcranking the camera, so get ready to handle a hot potato. The battery is smaller and results in less performance. I've been getting about an hour shooting video and an hour and a half to 2 hours shooting time lapses. The new Wi-Fi is great, but I do not like the dedicated Wi-Fi button. I keep accidentally turning it on and off. I wish it was in the menu. GoPro is now making a lens cap for the Hero 3. You can buy it separately, but it should be included with the camera. Also, the frame accessory is too expensive. 40 bucks for a piece of plastic? It should be half that, so I built my own. The old LCD back will work with the Hero 3, but I could not get it to turn off after a period of time while shooting, costing me battery power. Overall, I'm enjoying this camera. It is a great improvement on the Hero 2, and I suspect it only gets better from here. If you're looking to get a GoPro, this is a great choice. At $400, it's not cheap, so it may not be a good entry-level model. The days of these cameras being almost disposable are over, and it's becoming a professional tool. If you like this video, please subscribe and check out my playlist for several GoPro Hero 3 videos.